What should be the system design skill for the senior software engineer? This is the exact question I was pondering over a few years back. And like everybody else, I reached a roadblock in a few cases and I got success in a few places. So here I'll share both of those. First of all, what didn't work for me? A lot of people suggested me to go ahead and look for the interview preparation because interview preparations are generally the anchor points. You can get the common problem statements, and using those common problem statements, you can start to learn various systems. So for example, you can learn the system design of WhatsApp, you can learn the system design of YouTube, etc. This works perfectly fine for a lot of cases till the time you would need that breadth. But after a certain time, when you would have got the breadth, then you reach a roadblock. So most of the YouTube content covered the breadth. That is, for example, if you see the system design of WhatsApp, they would say that, hey, let's have a WebSocket based communication between the client to server and then server to client. Likewise, if you see the system design of a YouTube, they would say that, hey, just break the videos into the smaller pieces and then upload to CDN and then download from there. But we all can agree that the system would not be as simple as that. And if you want to get to the next level, you will need to catch up the depth as well. So for me, what I understood was that this is not the right approach. The right approach is not to look for the system and then try to dissect what would system be made of. Instead, have a bottom-up approach. Let's dissect any system into three different parts. The first part can be the network part of it. The second would be the database part or the storage part. And the third would be the processing part. So if I talk about the network part, these are the two services, service one, service two, or service one is the one service and the other can be database or the file system. We are talking about the communication between them. The communication can be with the help of HTTP, can be with the help of WebSockets, can be with the help of RTMP protocols, etc. So that's the first part, which you can master. The second is the database part. By database part, I mean that you can have a file system based storage, for example, distributed file systems, or you can have something like Cassandra or any NoSQL database or the relational databases, which are the default choices in most of the cases. And the third is the processing part. So what do you mean by processing part? That is, if we talk about one single machine, then we need to see what happens in that machine. For example, what language or technology you are planning to use, or what is the communication between the two processes, or the communication between the two classes, that is the low level design which we talk about. So three things. One is the network, how the services communicate between each other. The second is the storage, how do you store the data? And the third is, how do you process the data in the single machine? And these three things become very important the moment you embark your journey to the senior level, because now you would be expected to make the right design choices. You would be expected to choose whether to use Cassandra in a given problem statement or whether to use a relational database like MSSQL or non-relational database like MongoDB. So these things should be clear, and choosing the right technology is very important because it creates the base for a particular project and sometimes decides the future of the project as well. So let's talk about the first one, that is the network part of it. If you are talking about the chatting based application, then you can use or learn about WebSockets, long polling, or WebRTC. These are the common communication methods. If you are talking about the gaming applications, then you need to see when to use UDP and when to use TCP. You need to understand the differences between the two. If you are talking about the inter-process service communication, that is the service one and service two, then you can use HTTP, HTTP2, QUIC, or you can use gRPC, which is getting very popular nowadays. So you need to understand all these protocols so that you can choose when to use what. Because all the libraries, even if you use Java or C++, etc., they have such facilities to call the APIs, but you need to know when to use what. The second one is about the persistence layer, that is how you store the data. For example, either is it a file system problem or a database problem? If it's a file system problem, you can use something like HDFS. And if it's a database problem, you need to see whether you can choose relational database or you can choose NoSQL. Within NoSQL also, there are multiple options. For example, there is MongoDB, which is quite popular. Then there is Cassandra, which has its own use case around scalability. Then there are columnar databases like HBase. Then there is a Redis. So many options, and all of these options have their specific use cases. So it's important to understand the use case, talk to various people, see what is being used in financial domain, what is being used for the search purpose, etc. And then choose the right database. So there would be a use case in searching the data in the search page. There, the Elasticsearch might be useful. Likewise, there would be a use case where the transactions are important and their SQL would be useful. So it's equally important to understand about the databases as well. The third is around the processing part. So by processing, it is important to learn about the low-level design, when to use which pattern and when to have what sort of communication between the various classes. You might also need to understand the choice of the language. So you see, these are the three verticals which you would need to learn and understand so that you can choose the right one. Once you choose and learn these verticals, network part, the processing part, or the storage part, then a system design is nothing but joining these parts together. And then once you join those parts and take care of various factors like costing, etc., because you would need to get your hands dirty. If you get your hands dirty in WebRTC or you get your hands dirty in gRPC, you would know that how much is the learning curve, how much popular that language is, and what is the infrastructure needed for a particular framework. So once you do that, it will be easier for you to make the right choices or judge a system or propose a better system for the problem statements thrown to you. So that was my learning in the system design journey I have been doing so far. And it's always important to have an opinion on a particular technology, that when would you use it. If you see any documentation, most of the time they praise their technology, but the limitations are not highlighted much. So only if you get into the details, you would know what are the limitations of those technology. So once you do that, you would be able to reach to a next level. I am expecting you would have already covered one level of depth by going through the system design tutorials and system design courses. But having the control over the various layers of the system will help you even more. So that's all from my side for this week. If you like this video, please like and comment. It really makes a difference. Till the next time, bye.